tomato light, tomato light, shining bright in the darkest night. Tomato light, tomato light, shining bright in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
In the state of North Carolina, near the city of Wilmington, there's a place called Mako Station. That's where this story was begun. In 1867, they say a locomotive engineer whose name was Joe Baldwin died in a train wreck here. It was just before midnight, so they say, and the night was cold and black. Near the broken rail where the spikes had failed, Joe was standing on the track. The whistle screamed when the headlights gleamed, saw the warning light he gave. But the speeding freight and the hand of fate laid poor Joe in his grave. The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright in the darkest night. The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
From that day on, so the story goes, which no one won't deny, there's a ghostly light that appears at night like a halo in the sky. Though many have seen it, who really knows what makes the light appear? The old folks say it's the light of a lantern that Joe was a-swinging here. They say old Joe is surely a ghost that keeps coming back at night, still trying in vain to warn the train with the waving of his light. Well, maybe you believe it, or maybe you don't, or maybe you just won't tell. I've never been to either place, but I know there's a heaven and a hell.
The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright in the darkest night. The Mako light, shining bright
in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.